Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. When working with integrated VFX and grading in the timeline, the effects environment is a great place to tackle most of your creative requirements. Now, because of its versatility, there are quite a few components in the interface that you can set up when performing certain tasks. I'm referring to the viewers, media panels, storyboard scopes, timeline bar, as well as general behaviors of the controls. You can set these manually, but with the Flame 2020.1 update, we have introduced the ability to save your layouts to make things a lot easier as you work. So when you're working in the effects environment, you will find a layouts pull-down menu to the left of the player controls. When you open it, you will get two included layouts to help you get started, but I have already made a few of my own, which I'll show you at the end of the video. Default is the initial layout of the effects environment that you currently see. When you switch to compare previous and next shots, the interface updates to a 3-up view, but it also changes the time bar to show the entire timeline range. So this layout can help you with in-context grading and finishing. If you return back to the default layout, you have a single view and the time bar focuses back on a single segment duration. So the layouts don't only control what you see, it also will keep any interface settings that you would require for your layout. Now, it's rarely easy to create a layout, and once they're created, they'll appear in the pull-down menu. As a tip, you can have as many layouts as you like, and they are stored with your user profile. So to create your own layout, first you need to set up the interface the way you'd like, as well as the behaviors of the controls. For example, let's create a 2-up view, using one view for the result view and the other for the scopes. You won't need the media panel, so hide it with Control Swipe. Next, switch to a 2-up view with Alt 2 and enable the scopes in one of the viewers. You can also go ahead and choose any scope configuration you'd like. Now you can leave the storyboard or put it in the viewer. For the purposes of this example, just hide it through the player pull-down menu. In fact, here is where you could change the time bar behavior to show the whole segment, timeline range, etc. It's all up to you to configure what view you see and how the time bar behaves. Finally, set the positioners to all synced. This ensures that both views update when you scrub the time bar. Now let's say that this layout is what you'd like to save. So click the Layouts pull-down menu and choose Add Custom Layout. Let's call this layout 2-up with scopes. Now this pop-up window allows you to choose which settings are part of the new layout. So you'd want to include the media panel visibility and the viewports layout. You're not worried about the frame, timecode, and duration setting, but you'd like the same setting in the time bar range to be remembered. Cache on playback does not need to change with the layout, so ensure that option is off. The storyboard reel and display will be affected by the layout, so those are on. Finally, the behavior of the positioners with the viewers needs to be kept, so enable that setting. The remainder of the settings should not be affected by the layout. So when an option is included with the layout, it will automatically change. But when they are not included, they will keep their settings unless you manually change them, or another layout includes the settings as part of its customization. Click Add, and the custom layout is created. So when you toggle between the different layouts, it's super quick to set up the effects environment for your specific task. As a tip, if you wanted to update a specific layout, you can choose the layout in the list and make your changes to the interface and settings. If you create another custom layout with the same name, it will prompt you to overwrite the old one. Now you can manage these layouts by using the option in the pull-down menu. In this pop-up window, you can rename or even delete a layout. One point that is really cool is the ability to assign keyboard shortcuts to the different layouts. So close the pop-up and call up the keyboard shortcuts editor with Ctrl+Alt+F8 or through the Flame main menu. Perform a search for Select Layout. Now, even though you can create an unlimited number of layouts, you only have a maximum of 10 assignable slots. Let's assign a couple of shortcuts to learn how it works. Select the first layout entry and assign it to Control Meta 1. Remember to click Set for each assignment. Select the second layout and assign that to Control Meta 2. And finally, select one more layout and assign that to Control Meta 3. Click Save All to save all the shortcut modifications and close the editor. If you look at the Layouts pull-down menu, you will see the shortcut assignments next to each layout. So you can be really fast at switching layouts. Lastly, if you open the Manage Layouts pop-up window again, you can remap which keyboard shortcuts go to which custom layouts. So you don't have to go to the keyboard shortcuts editor each time you want to remap the layout shortcuts. Now, as an extra bonus for those of you using a tangent panel, the layout can also be mapped to the panel to keep your speed up. Finally, the layouts are tied to your user profile and are stored in an XML file. So for the more advanced users, you can access these layouts for wider distribution, as well as edit them externally if you want. Now, before I conclude this video, here are a couple of extra layouts I made earlier to give you a sense of what type of layouts you can create and how you could use these in your daily workflows. The Storyboard 2-Up layout has two viewports and displays the timeline context in one view and the storyboard in the other. I've turned off any displayed information in the thumbnails, and the time bar shows the entire timeline. This is a great contextual layout for grading, where you can view the entire timeline, navigate with the storyboard, and achieve in-context grading. The other layout, called Selector View with Manager, gives you three viewports, with the manager, the selector view, and the output result of the image timeline effects. So you can manage your selectives using the manager, view the segmentation and isolation of each selective, and finally see the overall result of all the selectives. This is all within one layout. Finally, layouts will also work on dual monitor systems, so you can take advantage of the extra real estate and create custom layouts that best work for your current setup. We hope that this usability enhancement will make working in the effects environment even more fluid for your VFX and grading workflows. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2020.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.